Thank you so much to the people in the audience that get these kids here for our 6:45 a.m. rehearsals. At this time, if you are a 7th and 8th grade student that assists with those first rehearsals, which means they come to jazz band 4 mornings a week. They come 2 days for themselves, they come 2 days to help the 6th graders. Can you raise your hand and be recognized for your contribution? During the band time. So if you are playing a different instrument than you normally do during band, would you raise your hand also? All right, they're going to finish their portion of the concert with a rock tune. It's one of their favorites, Grandpa Boogie. That sure is not a bad way to start your day every morning, especially when your morning starts at 6:45. So hopefully you enjoyed that, and then you can see the next part of the morning. So some of these fifth grade parents are thinking, hey, you mean it's earlier than this? Because thank you so much for making sure that your kids can get to the middle school 3, some of you 4 mornings a week for the band rehearsals. This is a huge night for these students. It's a huge night for our 6th graders as well. Last year we were not able to hold in-person concerts. So that was the first time the jazz band has ever performed. This is the first time the 5th graders have ever performed. And if you take a look at your program, and I shared this with your students this morning in band, but I wrote a letter to these beginners because it's a really big deal and they're part of something that I think is really awesome here at our school. So 5th graders, welcome to the band family. They're going to start with some of the exercises that we warm up with, and they will conclude the first portion of their concerts with the very popular hot cross buns. So if you could hold your applause till we get through that piece, because we can kind of transition to these quick songs quickly. Here's the 5th-8th band. Similar with this next set of pieces. It's okay to applaud after each one of these. We're going to add a few more notes and a little bit more complex melodies.
Thank you.
Everything we do in band each day builds on to what we do the next day, and it builds on to what you saw at the beginning of the concert and what you're going to see after that. So we are going to continue with our regular schedule for the rest of the week. There's no school for Lake Geneva Schools on Friday, so these percussion students won't have class on Friday, but we'll have our regular schedule tomorrow with woodwinds and percussion and Thursday full bands. Hopefully you saw the progression so far of what these students have done so far this school year, and they're going to conclude their portion of the concert with a tune called Beginning Band's Greatest Hits. So hopefully you recognize a few of these melodies and that you hear that they're not all doing the same thing at the same time, and it's meant to be that way.
Thank you.
be a very quick transition. Hold on, 5th grade, so we talked about how we're going over there, but we're going to go this way to get there, so that the 6th grade, we're going to just shift some kids around. This is challenging for them because this is a different setup than they're used to the classroom each day. We have another concert after that. I just have to take a moment and say, it's been a whirlwind tonight because it has been such a long time since we've been able to do these things that some of these students that normally would know what to do haven't experienced this either. So thank you for your patience. Hey guys, could you do it a little quieter so I can do our thank yous? Everything that you're seeing tonight happens because of many, many people behind the scenes. I have some really amazing assistants. Mrs. Jan Bjorkman, Mrs. Mary Bastianics-Jones, Mr. Zach Ott, and Mr. Ray Ames. So if you could please give a round of applause to those people. They help me with all of my lessons, day-to-day instruction, and without them, I would be completely lost. They are my best friends. They are also my family. I've never announced this at a band concert before, but I think I've been here long enough. One of those teachers was also my middle school band director, and he also happens to be my dad. So it's really cool to be able to work with friends and family. We have two amazing music colleagues here, Mrs. May and Mrs. Clement. I have an amazing high school theater program. Mr. Bungie, I know, is here this evening. These kids come to be knowing so much because their elementary music teachers, Mrs. May, Mrs. Kramer, and Mrs. Stanfield Dunham, do an amazing job at the elementary level. Thank you so much to all of the staff I work with here at LGMS and the Feeder School Star Center and ECU. A lot of those staff members are here this evening, and we also have concert supervisors helping them this evening. So thank you to them as well. Thank you to our custodians who helped turn this into a concert venue, and to the PE teachers for being incredibly accommodating and letting us move in here at the end of the day. We have a very supportive administration and school board. I also want to take a second to thank my family, particularly my husband, who helps with all of these events and chaperoning and is filming the concert this evening. And finally, thank you to you guys, to the band families, and to these band students. Without you, this wouldn't be a program. So thank you, and enjoy the 6th grade portion of the concert.
Thank you.
Talking to some of you guys at parent-teacher conferences and email. This next tune from Home Alone, Somewhere in My Memory, is one of their favorites, so I hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
All right, their final piece is called Name That Christmas Carol. When we're done with this piece, I'm going to ask you to kind of hang tight here so we can get everybody out of here to another concert quickly after this. So thank you so much for coming this evening. We hope you enjoy. And there's a little game inside your program. This tune is called Name That Christmas Carol, and you can count how many times you hear the different carols. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
All right, good evening. My name is Amanda Kouse, and I'm the 5th-8th grade band director for the Lake Geneva School District Joint 1. And this is the 7th and 8th grade jazz band, and welcome to our in-person winter concert. It has sure been a while. The students have worked very hard preparing for their winter concert. We ask at this time that you please silence your electronic devices and try to remain seated during the music. Please enter and exit the gym during transitions, and please do not congregate by the drinking fountains. This is our performance area. We have a very musically packed evening. I'm going to do my best to keep my announcements at a minimum. Hopefully, you were able to scan for our virtual program, or you were able to find it on the school website or in your email. Please be sure to read that virtual program to find out more about this evening's music, the personnel, the names of all the students performing this evening, the soloists, what we're doing. There's a lot of information in there. So we are going to continue with the 7th and 8th grade jazz band.
Thank you.
start our last number, 25 or 6 to 4. If you also come to, these guys come at 6:45 on Mondays and Wednesdays, but a number of these kids also come to school Tuesdays and Fridays to assist with the sixth grade jazz band. So busy kids are good kids. These are all good kids, but some of them come extra. If you raise your hand, if you come out and mentor the sixth graders for me. If you are playing an instrument right now that is different from what you play in concert band. So a lot of the students are doing that for the band. All right, here's our final tune.
Thank you. This group right here decided that they didn't have enough jazz in the morning. They wanted some more in the afternoon. So I'm really ecstatic, and I'm super proud of these kids for just deciding to get together, make their own band, choose their own songs, listen to this amazing music, and they're going to show off. So we've got Kate Steele on trombone, Olivia Weicker on tenor sax, Eli Vandenberg on alto, Malecki, Lizzie Malachi on piano, Nick Bowler on drums, and Olivia Martinez on bass. Check it out. This is what tune? Who wrote it?
Miles Davis.
Thank you.
not a bad way to end the day, right? All right, seventh grade, now you can play Jingle Bones. I know you're all excited.
All right, if you saw your concert program, you were supposed to feature, yep, guys, so right up here, they have their stands ready for you. You're supposed to feature Jonathan Peck, who is the son. The son of one of our principals, but he was ill today, out sick. You can see that some of my assistants might be stepping in and filling a couple of student roles tonight too, because tis the season. We're not just dealing with COVID, we are dealing with all the other things. So here is the seventh grade band, and they are playing a trombone feature called Jingle Bones.
Thank you.
few weeks ago, Mrs. May, one of my coworkers, was looking for music for her students and saw this really cool graphic on the website. Like, it was a barbaric Santa. And so she clicked on it and heard this piece. And I'm on these like really fun Band Director Facebook pages. And earlier that morning, I had heard about this piece. And I think she texted me or something. You have to do Santa the Barbarian. And I was like, I just discovered it. So she is not the barbarian. She is going to be the narrator this evening. We hope you enjoy.
I
stuff. But those kids all did all of that music from memory. So first, I'm going to apologize to Mr. Zatz for making I Want It That Way one of your Spotify top 20. Because we made him listen to it a few times to do that arrangement. Let's see. So they did that all from memory, and I talked about how busy these jazz kids are, and they're going, all of these kids are really busy. And already this year, they've done homecoming, which just isn't homecoming. They do a parade here, Star Center, Senden, Eastview. They march from Eastview to Senden. They do the football game. They've done Veterans Day. They've done the winter performance. I'm sure I'm missing other things. But it's really amazing to me to see what these kids do. I am very proud of them. And like I said, what we just did there, hopefully we made a seamless transition. By the way, the drummers even switched drums during that. And so they kept that beat and the marching and stuff, and they look great. So thank you guys for all of the support that you do. We're gonna keep going. What are we on, guys?
Thank you.
Well, the percussionists are transitioning. I am going to just take a moment to do a lot, and I'm gonna try to keep them quicker this time. Thank yous. All of this could not be done without the help of many. So first of all, I have amazing assistants. This is Jan Bjorklund, this is Mary Gaskanis Jones, Mr. Zach Ott, and Mr. Ray Ames. They do so much behind the scenes, helping in rehearsals, doing lessons. I couldn't do this without them. Please give them a round of applause. My department here, Mrs. May and Mrs. Clement, they're the best colleagues, they're the best of friends. I also have an amazing person, also a very good friend of mine, but I can send these kids over to Badger, Mr. Greg Longley. So if you could give those guys a round of applause, please. These kids come to me and know so many things, and what's happening at the elementary schools is fostering here. So Mrs. Kim May, Mrs. Karen Kramer, Mrs. Amy Stanfield Dunham did an amazing job at the elementary school. Please give another round of applause. Finally, you can see so many of these people in our audience tonight, but there is an incredible staff at LGMS. Many of them are working the concerts, many of them have their own students here, many of them are here just because they love these kids. So maybe give a round of applause for all of our district teachers. For allowing us to turn this into a performance center tonight. We have, obviously, we can't get this without super supportive administration and school board, so please recognize them. I also need to thank my family, my kids, my husband. They let me do this thing, and I am gone a lot of hours. My husband chaperones everything. He's filming the concert this evening, but thank you to my family, and most of all, thank you to you and these band students to make it all possible. So thank you very much. Thank you for listening to me.
Thank you.
The winter band concert is always the second Tuesday after Thanksgiving. But today also marks the 80th anniversary of Pearl Harbor, December 7th, 1941. That's an event that brought the United States into World War II. At this time, the 8th grade band is going to perform taps to honor the over 2,400 Americans that died 80 years ago today.
Father, I show you
All right, we have one more combined number for you. And then I'm going to get kind of bossy so that we can get all of this stuff back into the music department. And these kids are really great at doing it. So if you could just like hang tight. But here is the combined 7th and 8th grade band doing Feliz Navidad.